Does an apple a day really keep the doctor away? Stay tuned for a surprising answer. An apple a day keeps the doctor away contains more truth than you might think. Fruits are known as our protective foods. They protect us from certain illnesses in a number of ways. Called the king of fruits, the apple is one of the most universally liked fruits. It has eye appeal, taste appeal, aroma appeal, and crunch appeal. There are over 6,000 varieties of apples. In the tropics, people have an abundance of pineapples, mangoes, papayas, and bananas, but are still willing to pay high prices for apples, which come from colder climates. Besides being a good source of vitamins, minerals, fibers, and energy, apples have been acclaimed for their medicinal value in intestinal disorders, an aid to digestion, and killing of bacteria. An interesting study reported by Dr. H.T. Knighton of Louisville, Kentucky, speaking before American Dental Association on experiments in reducing tooth decay, said, chewing apples eliminated 96.7% of the bacteria, while sliced oranges and paraffin tied for second with 95% ratings. 3 minutes of toothbrushing plus a mouth rinsing was a poor seventh, bagging only 64.3% of the microbes. There is evidence that detergent fruits are more effective mouth cleansers than the toothbrush. Fruits abound the world around. We should eat generously of fresh fruits. Fruits play a major role in cooking by God's book. The Lord God planted all sorts of beautiful trees there in the garden, trees producing the choicest of fruits. Here is how fruits help to keep us well. 1. Fruits are appetizers. Their juicy, attractive appearance and flavor tempt the appetite. Food eaten with relish is digested quickly. The mouth's watering for a food means that the digestive juices are being stimulated. This stimulation prepares the stomach for food so that digestion begins at once. 2. Fruits are low in calories and high in fiber. They contain a large amount of water. Fruits have been called blood cleansers or purifiers. 3. Fruits are one of our best sources of vitamins. 4. Fruits are a good source of minerals. 5. Fruits are a natural sweetener for healthful desserts, as you will see when we get to our dessert lesson. 6. Fruits are good regulators. One of the fundamental health rules is irregular bowel movement. Fruit has a most wholesome effect on the intestines and elimination process. Both the fiber and the acid which fruits contain produce a laxative effect. 7. Fruits contain energy value. Fruits vary greatly in the number of calories which they contain. Dried fruits are no more expensive as a source of energy than butter, milk, or cheap cuts of meat. And fresh fruits, judged on energy alone, are as economical as good cuts of meat. And 8, fruits are an important part of a Weight Watchers diet due to their low-calorie, high-water content. 9, a substance in fruit called pectin has a cholesterol-reducing effect. For your information, the National Academy of Sciences recommends consuming 5 or more servings of fruits and vegetables daily, and 6 servings of grain or grain products and legumes each day. Is there room for much else? In a recent rethinking of our basic food needs, nutrition authorities are looking at replacing the old basic 4 food groups concept with a new guide to daily food choices, called the Eating Right Pyramid. This is exciting news as science comes closer to lining up with God's recommended eating plan. At the base of our diet are grain products in the form of breads, cereals, rice, or pastas, 6 to 11 servings each day. As the second most predominant type of food we should eat each day comes vegetables and fruits, 3 to 5 servings of vegetables and 2 to 4 servings of fruits are recommended. As we approach the top of the pyramid, dairy products, meat, poultry, fish, dry beans, eggs, and nuts are listed in smaller amounts than the first two groups. Milk products, 2 to 3 servings per day. Of the protein foods, 2 to 3 servings. At the tip top, to use sparingly, are the fats, oils, and sweets. The Eating Right pyramid is an outline of what to eat each day. Wherever you live around the world, fruits for health and vitality are essential to a good eating plan. Because of the acid, canned fruits retain their vitamin C very well in the canning process. If a fruit was a good source when raw, it is likely to be a good source when canned. Canned fruit is also often less expensive than fresh fruit, especially when fresh fruit is not at the height of its season. Because dried fruit contains much sugar, it has good fuel or energy value. It contains the good qualities of fresh fruit, except for vitamin C, which may be wholly or partly destroyed in drying. Because of their concentration, dried fruits are particularly good sources of iron, calcium, and phosphorus. However, care should be taken in the preparation of dried fruit to prevent the loss of minerals, which are soluble in water. The water in which the fruit is soaked would be mostly absorbed by the fruit in cooking. The remaining juice should be served with the fruit. Here are several varieties of apples. You can do so many things with apples. A quick uncooked applesauce can be made in an electric blender. Let's do it. Put one medium sliced apple, any sweet variety such as the Golden Delicious, into your electric blender. We're just leaving the skins on because they have fiber and nutrition to add to it. 1/4 cup pineapple juice to keep the color from turning dark, and just a little teaspoon of honey or a couple of pitted dates for a little added sweetening. Whiz it up until it's smooth. Need a little more juice. Okay, let's put a little more juice. We have a big apple here. Want to be sure it can move and whiz up to sauce. There we go. And you can serve this immediately or chill it for a little while before serving. Let's put this into a nice little dish and get it ready to serve. This is fresh applesauce made from Golden Delicious apples. One simple way to use apples for part of any meal is to bake them, especially when winter apples are not as crisp as they once were. Try this recipe for stuffed baked apples. You want to wash your apples, and you could use Rome Beauties, Golden Delicious, or any other kind of apples that you may grow right in your own yard. Take an apple peeler or a knife and core out the center of each one. We're going to put a stuffing down in the center and bake these in an oven. Okay, we're going to prepare a little filling to put inside. Mix 3 tablespoons of raisins, 3 tablespoons of chopped nuts, we're using walnuts, and put a tablespoon of a mixture in the center. We have a little coriander and cardamom for flavor here. They are two nice herbs that give you sort of a cinnamon type flavor. You can use a little brown sugar, a fourth to a half a cup, depending on how many apples you want to stuff, and a little lemon juice for tartness. Mix it all together. And we just want to stuff our mixture right down into the centers of these apples. Pack it clear to the bottom. I can smell it already. This is a nice, refreshing way to have an apple in the wintertime. It even makes a nice dessert. We eat baked apples for breakfast too. So you can use a lot of apples in your meals, as we've heard at the beginning of our lesson. Right, you want to pour water in the bottom of your baking dish for about a fourth of an inch to cover so that it won't dry out. And we'll need to bake these in the oven for at 375 degrees until tender when pierced with a fork. It takes about 45 minutes. And here you have the baked apples. You can just serve it in a little dish or a little bowl and serve it with plain yogurt or a little cream or some topping that you might like. When possible, fruits eaten fresh, uncooked, are the best. But during the winter time, when fresh fruits may be too expensive where you live, dried fruits can be rehydrated to make delicious dishes. Fresh fruit salad for a light supper with muffins or bread is a delicious way to end a summer day. Simply combine several kinds of fresh fruits, serve in a pretty dish with or without the dressing. Really don't need a recipe for making fresh fruit salads, do we? Here we have a mixture of the fruits that are in season here right now. Strawberries, bananas, little papaya. They're not in season here, but we have these. Little coconut over the top. And served with a muffin, this would make a very nice summertime supper. Some sliced fresh fruits, such as apples, bananas, pears, and apricots and peaches, may discolor upon sitting. By dipping them into orange or pineapple juice or any high vitamin C juice, they retain their color. So if you're going to serve a fruit salad, make it just a little bit ahead, you want to slice the cut pieces into some kind of high vitamin C juice so that they will hold their color for the duration of the time. We've dipped these in some pineapple juice, and then we can add them to our fruit salad. Something else that you can do with fruit called Luau Delight. We're going to be combining 1.5 cups of cold cooked brown rice. And 1.5 cups of pineapple chunks or tidbits, drained. 2 tablespoons of honey. One-third cup chopped walnuts, or any kind of nuts that you have. And 1/2 cup of fine, dried, unsweetened coconut. You make, stir it all together and fold in 1 cup of low-fat whipped topping just before serving. We're just going to set this aside and we're making a whipped topping for you in just a moment. Here you have a nice energy dish for a light summer meal. Luau Delight. We have a salad dressing for fruit salads in place of whipped cream that saves adding extra calories and fat to the meal. What we've done is mix 2 tablespoons of cornstarch with 1/4 cup of orange juice until it's smooth. Bring 1 cup pineapple juice to boiling and stir a little amount of the cornstarch into the mixture. Then add to the boiling pineapple juice. Stir constantly as it cooks slowly. It takes about 2 minutes. Cool it, and you can see it's thick. And when this is cold, this is wonderful to stir into fruit salads or to just put over the top of many of your light fruit type desserts. It's a nice low calorie topping for fruit salads. Because this fruit salad dressing contains two high vitamin C fruit juices, it will keep fresh fruits such as apples and bananas, pears and peaches from turning brown. This dressing keeps well also in the refrigerator. An alternative to whipped cream for fruit salad is the following topping made with low-fat or non-fat yogurt. Stir in 1 cup of plain low-fat yogurt, 1 teaspoon of grated orange rind. Just take a grater and with your finest grate, just grate some of the rind off. You need about 1 teaspoon. 2 tablespoons of orange juice. 2 tablespoons honey. A pinch of ground coriander. And a drop or two of almond flavoring, which is an optional thing, but it adds just a little zest to it. Stir. You can just cover and refrigerate this and chill it until it's ready to use. This is a nice dressing to put onto our luau delight that we made earlier. You can mix this and fold it all into the luau delight. Or when you serve these up individually, you can just put a little dollop over the top of each person's serving. It's an alternative to whipped cream for salads. And for variation, you could add 2 tablespoons of powdered pectin, the same kind of pectin that you use for jelly making. And it gets even thicker and smoother consistency that simulates a higher oil or cream content without any cream. Another fun thing to do is to make stuffed peaches. We mix 1 tablespoon of honey and 1 tablespoon of chopped almonds or other nuts. And we add 2/3 of a cup of small curd cottage cheese, low fat. And fold in 1 medium banana that's thinly sliced. And mound the cottage cheese banana mixture into some peach halves for a lovely salad or main dish supper or for a light dessert even. You could use the same stuffing for cantaloupe, and it also makes a wonderful filling for crepes, for a nice crepe breakfast. You can also use other fruits instead of peaches, such as pears, are also nice. Whatever fruit is in season, use your imagination and put something together. It's fun to take fresh fruits and just do creative arrangements with them so that they are beautifully done to serve. You can take a pineapple, a whole pineapple, and slit it in half the lengthwise and then cut it in each half again so that you have 4 individual sections. Then if you take a knife, you can get right under the rind part and cut it loose so that you can get it free. And then do the same underneath so that you're cutting underneath close to the base of the skin there. You do it on both sides so that you could actually take the pineapple right out from its position. You can slide it out. And you can cut this into strips and put it back in the pineapple again in a decorative manner, just alternating on each side. You can stuff other colored fruits in between each one of these pieces or leave it plain. Serve this on a beautiful platter as the fruit dish for a party or for luncheons. So this is our quick pineapple boats. The advantage of fruits is immeasurable. Eat abundantly of fresh fruits. Remember to eat only healthy fruits and vegetables, not showing any signs of the slightest decay, but sound and unaffected by any disease or decay. If a fruit is bruised from falling on the ground, it's safe to eat. But if a fruit is decayed or moldy, it should not be eaten. God has a special way of packaging nature's foods to tell us how freely we can eat of each kind. Fruits and vegetables generally come in juicy, easy to open, or ready to eat packages such as apples, pears, peaches, melons, berries, tomatoes, cucumbers, which is God's way of saying, eat generously of these foods. Other packages in nature are smaller and harder to open, such as coconut and walnuts and other nuts, which is God's way of saying, eat more sparingly of these foods. Because even though nourishing, they are more concentrated and higher in calories. A monkey is about the only expert at opening coconuts in a hurry. Nuts and seeds are a good source of protein and fat, but as you remember from our eating right pyramid, we need lesser amounts each day of these foods. Keep in mind, too, that if you had to hand crack each nut or sunflower seed you ate, you would be less likely to overeat on them. When we purchase nuts and seeds already shelled for us, we can easily overeat even of good food. Healthful eating principle number 15 is about fruit. It states that it is best to serve fruits at one meal, vegetables at another for better digestion. Fruits and vegetables require different digestive enzymes to digest them, and it is therefore less complicated to eat them at separate meals. You will notice that we recommend eating several fruits for breakfast, vegetables with the dinner meal, and one or the other for the evening meal. I am thankful to our Creator God for the blessing of fresh fruits. Dear God, thank you for providing us with fruits to nourish our bodies. Thank you for the Bible, which is your instruction manual for us to live by. Give us understanding as we search its pages for the laws of health that you have provided for us. Bless the viewers in a special way as they endeavor to implement your ideal eating plan. Amen.
Recipes shown in this program are available in Marcella Lynch's companion cookbook, Cooking by the Book. This 315-page cookbook is filled with healthful plant-based recipes and meal ideas that are delicious and easy to make. These low-fat, low-cholesterol dishes will help your family get a balanced diet that promotes better health. To order Cooking by the Book, call 1-800-655-9071 or you may email to lynchmarcella@gmail.com.